60-52 win here at Haas Pavilion, a road win at Cal to get to 10 wins overall, 2-0 in conference, while the Bears fall to 9-7, 2-3. With Don McClain, J.B. Long, Jaime Jaquez Jr. was questionable with an ankle to play this game. He looks strong.
He affects the game in a lot of different ways. If you need him to score, he can do that. If you need him to rebound, he does that. Defend, whatever you need to win games, Jaquez can do. A slow night for Juzang, so they needed Jaquez's production. 14 from him, 6-9 from the floor. But he just, I said at the end of the game, he just makes winning plays. He does what's necessary for your team to win. And glad, if you're a UCLA fan, glad to see him back and not miss any time because of that ankle. And Andre Kelly was really good here tonight. 22 points, 6 rebounds, 11 of 14. UCLA really didn't have an answer for him. Think about if the game was played faster, JB, with more possessions, how many Kelly would have had. And so a big-time weapon for Mark Fox and Cal is Andre Kelly, especially in that screen roll game.
One of my takeaways from this trip to Berkeley is going to be Mark Fox, Cal's head coach, saying that Tiger Campbell deserves Pac-12 Player of the Year consideration.
I hadn't really thought about that because, again, Jaquez, Juzang get the headlines. But if you really drill down deep on UCLA and see why they win, Campbell might have the biggest effect on that because of his game management, his distribution, and now the three-point shooting, which we talked about in the open, leading the Pac-12 in three-point percentage.
All right, so the Bruins home to face the Oregon programs next week. Cal is going to wrap up this homestand and hit the road. They're off to UW midweek. 60-52 is the final. Top five UCLA resuming its pursuit of a Pac-12 championship. And who knows, maybe return trip to the Final Four.